Hey guys, thanks for joining me for Let's Get Lippy. I'm just going to be reviewing a couple of these lip products. I don't have many, and all of them are drugstore, so they are really affordable. Definitely with anything you do, you want the freshest skin possible. And I'm sure you've heard lots of time using a toothbrush on your lips to get rid of some of the dead skin. You just want to make sure that it is very soft bristles, so you're not damaging any of your skin cells. It's definitely not a good thing. You don't want to make them sensitive or red. Another thing you can do is take a little olive oil and sugar, and this is all natural, so it's okay to ingest if you get some on your lips. And actually, if you have an empty lipstick case, you can actually just make it so you have it right near your toothbrush in the morning. And your measurements don't have to be exact either. So just put a little bit of olive oil in the container and a tiny bit of sugar. And there you go, you have your traveling lip exfoliator. All you have to do is mix it up. You want to make sure you get some of that sugar in there. And you're just going to go in circle motions and take off the dead skin. If a little gets in your mouth, you'll be alright. So that's a good thing to know. So once you have soft lips, I'm just going to recommend a few of the lip balms or chapsticks I use to keep your moisture in, especially in the winter since it's so dry. And I'm just going to start with treatments to lip balms and chapsticks. The first one is actually Burt's Bees, but I can't find it anywhere. But I wanted to give it a thumbs up because it's really good and I do recommend it a lot. I had it, I don't know, it's somewhere in my room. I think it's probably in a pocket somewhere or in a coat pocket. But either way, I really do love it. It's a great chapstick. It smells nice. I'm not sure if it's all natural. I probably should have researched that. But I think it's on definitely more of the natural side if it isn't all natural, which is great for people who are putting on their kids' lips or, you know, putting extra chemicals into your body. This is my cat. She's got a big tail. But, oh my gosh. Okay, so just to start, I have a second runner-up or maybe tie for first place is Blistex. This one here is in the balm. I really, really like it. This one here is for, it says for cold sores, cracked lips, and dry lips, which I luckily have never had a cold sore, but I'm a victim to dry lips. So I definitely reach for this when I have dry lips. It has that menthol-y, minty, actually it's kind of like Vicks, like it gives you that clear your nose kind of feeling, and it's just a really nice balm. It actually comes in a squeeze gloss, kind of similar to this one, with this top like this. It's similar to that, and also it comes in a chapstick, so whatever you're more comfortable with the balms, like you obviously get it on your finger. I don't know if you like that or not. A little bit messy, but I just like the feeling of how creamy it is. Alright, so a couple of the other medical or more like moisturizing lip balms I have is this one. My friend got it from the body shop just for Christmas for me, and it has a rosy smell, so it might have some rose water in it. Let me see. It says it's not tested on animals, which is great. And the directions are just pat on as needed. And the great thing about this is that it is good for your lips, your cuticles, your elbows, your knees. And it also says your face, which I wouldn't really recommend since it is oily. As you can see there. So I don't think you'd really want this on your face unless you were desperate. Or maybe before you go to bed. The nice thing is this is because it's an all-in-one, so you can throw in your purse, and no matter what, if you have dry cuticles, your lips, your elbows are cracking, you know, you have dry skin, you can throw it on there and know that you're safe. It's not going to be too oily since it's supposed to be, it's all-purpose. Another one is Nivea Lip Care. Now, Nivea is great for skincare. It's well-known for skincare. For some reason, I don't really like this. It's nothing special. I don't think that it, does anything spectacular. It just is really plain. I feel like it's like more of a gloss rather than moisturizing. Like, I don't think Nivea really outdid themselves. Let me just see here if it says. Yeah, it doesn't say it has SPF or anything. Like, it doesn't blow your mind in any way possible. Another one I have is from Europe. I'm not even sure if they sell it in Canada or the USA, but it's called Labello. If I'm saying that wrong, I apologize. But it says that it is a care gloss and shine. I definitely feel like it is not really that much of a care gloss, as it says it's supposed to be a treatment as well as a shine. I don't think it's really that spectacular as a treatment, but if you find something that makes your lips look good and feel good, like, please let me know, because that is wonderful. 2-in-1 is perfect. I feel like they definitely concentrated more on to the shine part of, like, the lip gloss part rather than something you could grab when you have really dry lips. So I wouldn't suggest that for dry lips. Okay, and then I just have a lot of lip glosses. I used to be huge into, like a nude lip, and then I got really, really experimental and moved to a light pink to a kind of more of a bright pink. It's pretty sad. I'm not really that experimental. But here are my wide variety of colors. All over the rainbow, they're all pink, so it's sad. So I'll just show you what I have in lip glosses right now. Like I said already, I don't have many, but these are just the few I can think of to show you. Number one is this Sally Hansen Lip Inflation, and it has like the kind of like the painter flat brush. It goes on really nice. I don't know how much it really makes that, like, usually like you get a tingler feeling. I think Sally Hansen has, I've used Sally Hansen's where it's clear and it really, you could feel it in your lips, the inflation in your lips. This one, not so much. It doesn't really do too much. I think that it has a lot of shine to it, which obviously gives the illusion of having bigger lips, but I don't think it really, really makes them any more plump. So it is supposed to be a plumper. It isn't really anything too special, but the color's nice. It's kind of like a beigey. It has some gold flecks in it. They have lots of colors. I think it kind of does what it says, but it's not like wow. It doesn't have the wow factor. A couple other ones here is another Sally Hansen. This one is supposed to be for, it's supposed to make your teeth look whiter. So I wish Sally Hansen could have achieved all of these things with big lips and white teeth. That'd be perfect, but unfortunately I really don't feel this actually made my teeth look any whiter. If anything, it made them look less white. This one here is in Gleaming. It's a Smile Brightener Lip Treatment. I didn't feel like it made my teeth that white, so if it doesn't do what it says, not that great. It has lots of other shades. Maybe the other shades were better. This one has almost like a purple fleck to it, which really isn't my cup of tea anyways, but I thought maybe I could throw in something new there with my pinks, but I didn't really achieve it with that one. I've used it probably twice and didn't like it. Another one I've used and I didn't really like that much was this Energizing Lip Shine from Wet n Wild. And the lip gloss itself is okay. It has kind of this applicator. The only reason I haven't used it is it's the smell. I don't know, like, I was kind of sick when I bought it, so I think it turned me off right from the beginning. When I smelled it, it made me feel kind of sick. But it just has, like, it's like a menthol, but, like, bad, like, mint, like, it's supposed to be, like, green tea, like, I don't know, it's just, I don't recommend the smell, really. And once you get, like, if you're draining your lips, it's all you can smell. Once you don't like something, it's hard to change.